Antonio Vaccaro was newly married when he volunteered in World War II. A radio engineer at WHEB in Portsmouth turned Army tech sergeant.
I guess what the favorite memory for me was on VJ Day when the Japanese broke in off frequency, said they wanted to surrender.
Now 100 years young, a widower with a large, close-knit family who still lives independently.
What's a secret? I don't know. Smoking one cigar a day.
His warmth spread through five generations gathering at Portsmouth City Hall as the service of a humble family man and soldier is honored.
As a communications chief for the renowned Flying Tigers, Tony was instrumental in the fight against the Japanese. He jerry-built and maintained radio equipment used by the squadron, and he developed a relationship with Chinese leader Chiang Kai-shek.
He's credited with climbing into the hills, accompanied by five Chinese soldiers, to rig up the radio beacons that brought the Enola Gay home after dropping its atomic cargo in Japan.
I put the direction finders on top of some mountains. When they dropped the atomic bombs, they couldn't come back to where they came from. They had to fly over, pick up my homing devices, and come to our field.
Now honored with six medals, recognition he never asked for, but so deserves.
Thank you, and thank you for your service.
Oh, thank you, dear. I'm glad to do my part.
In Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.